What if just one planet in our solar system suddenly disappeared? Hi, welcome to Insane Curiosity. Have you ever noticed how beautiful our solar system is? Planets, asteroids, moons, everything seems to be in perfect harmony. Physical laws of nature hold together both rocky and gaseous planets, whether they're small or big. Philosophers and scientists of all eras noticed this as well. But it was only with Newton that we understood what was holding everything so perfectly together. It was gravity. As of today, we know that gravity is responsible for the amazing dance of planets in space. It's what gives them their spherical shape. However, have you ever wondered what would happen if one of the planets suddenly disappeared? What would happen to this perfect harmony? If only one of the planets disappeared, the loss of gravity might manifest itself with some strange effects. For example, as we will see later in this video, if Jupiter disappeared, Mercury, Venus, Earth, and Mars would be in serious danger. First of all, every planet is different. If there's one thing that we learned, and we're still learning with new studies on exoplanets, about planets is that there are plenty of them, and they have different sizes, different compositions, different shapes and mass distribution. And they also have a different axis of rotation and different angular velocities. In general, the gravitational field of a planet produces is mostly determined by its mass. According to Newton and its universal law of gravitation, every object is attracted to each other, and the pull of this force is greater, the greater the mass of the objects in play. Basically, the disappearance of a small planet, for example, won't affect the behavior of the other planets so much. In this video, we will see what would happen to Earth if the other planets suddenly disappeared. And we will see that, for small planets like Venus or Neptune, nothing strange will happen. But keep in mind that these effects don't hold forever. Planetary systems are in general quite unstable. This in physical terms means that even a slight change in their orbits could lead, on timescales of millions or billions of years, to the disappearance of the system as a whole. Let's throw Mercury away first. Get out! Mercury is the first and smallest of all the planets in our solar system. It's the closest to the Sun, and its gravity is heavily influenced by the Sun because the Sun's huge. As you might already know, the Sun is the most massive body in the solar system. It accounts for over 99.8% of the solar system mass. This said, Mercury's disappearance on short timescales would cause negligible changes to the solar system's order. The small size of the planet and its proximity to the Sun causes it to be merely a speck in the solar system. How many times did you happen to watch the sky at night and see a bright, not sparkling needle on the horizon? That was probably Venus. Venus can appear as a brilliant evening star. Besides the Sun and the Moon, Venus is the brightest object visible in Earth's sky. Because it is closer to the Sun than Earth, Venus never strays far from the Sun in its apparent position, and is seen during the year as either a bright morning or evening star. Let's try to kick Venus out of the system. What would happen? Well, the loss of Venus would not have many cosmological effects, but it would certainly hurt the night sky as we would lose our morning star. The sky would be much less bright and the world less romantic. So the Earth would still be safe if we got rid of Mercury or Venus. Will things change if Mars suddenly disappeared? Well, first of all, it would be a pity for us humans because we're planning to live there one day. Mars is the most explored planet in the solar system. More than 56 exploratory missions were sent to study the red planet in great detail. If Mars vanishes, basically nothing happens to Earth orbit, but on long time scales, you would notice a decrease in the number of asteroids coming towards Earth. This is because Mars acts as a slingshot, accelerating some of the objects in the asteroid belt towards Earth. It's a paradox, but we would be safer if Mars didn't exist. Isn't it amazing? Let's see how this mechanism works. Shortly, asteroids are firmly held by Jupiter's huge gravity, but sometimes, due to an effect called gravity resonance, they get pushed out of the orbit. The Sun, exerting its huge gravity on this anomaly, pulls the asteroid towards it. Here, Mars's gravity comes into play. Mars acts as a slingshot and hurdles the asteroid towards Earth. Even though these asteroids may fly by with several million miles to spare, Mars does increase the probability of Earth-bound asteroids. Let's move outwards and reach Jupiter. Jupiter is the big brother of the solar system. It's the second most massive body and is really important for life as we know it here on Earth. What Jupiter does is protect us from space bullies. Over the past billion years, Jupiter acted as a shield for Earth and the rocky planets of the solar system because it has a huge gravitational field. It's actually so vast and strong that it can derail the asteroids bound for Earth and cast them out of the solar system. In this animation, you can appreciate how the comet Shoemaker-Levy literally fell into Jupiter in 1994. In fact, long-range comets frequently crash into it, leaving some impressive scars. Earlier on this channel, we made a video about this topic. Why don't you check it out? Also, if Jupiter disappears and its moons stay, then there is a possibility that some of the moons may hit other celestial bodies in our solar system, and others may eventually start orbiting the Sun. Moreover, our very purpose in establishing colonies on Mars was to save the human race from extinction. But with Jupiter gone, Mars won't be safe either. So our mission to save mankind will have to take great interstellar leaps. For the cherry on top, although this is still not confirmed, Jupiter's disappearance could impact our climate a little bit. So please, guys, don't let Jupiter disappear. Saturn is the sixth planet of the solar system and the second largest member. Somebody calls it the Lord of the Rings due to its beautiful set of rings, which makes it look quite majestic. Look at it as seen from the Cassini spacecraft. Saturn also has 62 moons, one of which is Titan with a size greater than Mercury. Titan is the largest moon of Saturn and the second largest natural satellite in the solar system. It's the only moon known to have a dense atmosphere and is the only known object in space, other than Earth, on which clear evidence of stable bodies of surface liquid has been found. Saturn's disappearance would affect the orbits of Jupiter and Uranus by some degree, due to its sheer size and mass. But given its distance from the inner ring of planets, it's tough to imagine that Saturn would have a similar impact on the smaller inner planets. Well, up to this point, it seems only Jupiter could really have some major impact on the density of Earth. But what about the two planets left, Uranus and Neptune? Hey, before getting to Uranus and Neptune, why don't you subscribe and press the bell notification? In this way, you won't miss any of our videos. Well, Uranus is big, but it is also so distant. As we know, the universal law of gravitation tells us that the gravitational pull is inversely proportional to the distance of the objects taken into consideration. Since Uranus is too far away, the force acting on the other planets is negligible. But of course, it definitely affects the outer rings of the solar system, including the Kuiper Belt. But let's make it funnier. Let's suppose we put Uranus next to our planet, everything else being unchanged. In this case, the tides would be ripped off our planet, and the gravitational pull of a planet so massive would tear our planet apart. We would all die. So if someone ever asked you to choose between making Uranus disappear or placing it close to Earth, you better go for the first option. Nothing strange will happen if Neptune disappeared, but, as we were saying earlier, this is only valid on short timescales. As an example, let's see what would happen to the solar system in the long run if there was a 0.1% change in Neptune's orbit. This would be enough for the planets to collide. Astrophysicists explain that if Neptune's orbit suddenly underwent this small change, a neighboring star that gets too close to our solar system could throw it into chaos. This is strongly supported by simulations. According to them, a passing star would only have to shift Neptune's position by 3 times the distance between Earth and the Sun to confuse planets. Simulations are a really important tool for astrophysicists. Numerical simulations are used to investigate a variety of astrophysical phenomena, including to investigate the distribution of dark matter on large and small scales. To understand X-ray clusters and their properties, to perform high-resolution simulations of the interstellar medium and the formation and evolution of galaxies, to model the disruption of Milky Way satellites, to investigate how planets form and how their atmospheres evolve under extreme conditions, to determine how the first stars in the universe form, to simulate the electrodynamics of neutron stars. Last but not least, the outcome of a simulation should always be able to reproduce what we observe in the universe. A simulation that can't reproduce the observations is probably based on bad physics. If that happens, it might be time to revise out theories. So what we learned today is that, surprisingly enough, the removal of a planet, with the exception of Jupiter, would not change the world around us as drastically as you may imagine. The changes brought about by their departure would be minuscule in the immediate moment, but over time the changes might gradually increase. A million years down the line, it's hard to say how those changes would interact and evolve. So stay calm and chill. The universe and our solar system are safer than you think. Perhaps the most dangerous thing in the solar system is the human presence. Let's be kind to our planet and everything will be just fine. That's all for this video. What did you think about it? Let us know in the comments below and be sure to watch our other videos about the solar system through the YouTube end screens and in the description below.